Mahatma Gandhi is a highly religious man. For him, as he puts it, a prayer was real. A prayer, he says, is as real as eating and walking and sleeping. And he believed in multiculturalism. He believed in all religions. He believed that there should be secularism and India should be a multi-religious state. And he spent a lot of time and effort in trying to bridge the misunderstandings between the Hindu community and the Muslim community. He wanted to bring them together. He staked his own life for this cause, and ultimately he was killed for this cause. If I were to talk about the two greatest Hindus, so to say, then I must point out there Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda, and Mahatma Gandhi. Vivekananda is known for the great speech he gave in Chicago. And I think it is worth going to the text of the speech, which is available on the internet, and also the sound is available, but not in Vivekananda's voice. I think this is one of the greatest speeches of Vivekananda, and I'm going to read a small section of it to you, because Vivekananda talks about Hinduism, which propagates universal brotherhood. He says that sectarianism, bigotry, and its horrible descendant, fanaticism, have long possessed this beautiful earth. They have filled the earth with violence, drenched it often and often with human blood, destroyed civilization, and sent whole nations to despair. Had it not been for these horrible demons, human society would be more advanced than it is now. And I'm very sad that these demons of fanaticism are raising their heads again. And it is very important to understand Gandhi and Vivekananda to fight them, to get rid of them. I get very pained when I see the fanatics parading pictures of Vivekananda and pictures of Gandhi when they are propagating their idea, their version of distorted Hinduism. Gandhi prayed every day. He started something which was the inter-religious, inter-faith prayer meeting in his ashram. Mahatma Gandhi's ashram never had a temple, a mosque, or a gurudwara, or a church. There were prayers from all religions sung at one place. And it is very interesting to know where this came from. His grandson, Rajmohan Gandhi, has written about it. Mahatma Gandhi was going to South Africa somewhere in 1897-98, and the ship in which he was going faced a big storm just off coast Zanzibar, and everybody was almost convinced that this ship is going to sink now. So everybody, there were Hindus, there were Muslims, there were Christians, all of them started praying. It was Mahatma Gandhi and the captain who were trying to control them, solace them, give them courage. And they were all praying, and Gandhi says that I heard sounds of prayers. There were prayers to Jesus Christ, there were prayers to Shiva, and there were prayers to Allah. The sounds were different, but the spirit was the same. And that recognition of the spirit, the same spirit during the prayers of different religions, made Gandhi start the interfaith prayers in his ashram. Gandhi believes that if you want to understand your religion better, you have to respect other religions. He says it is not just enough to respect other religions, you have to love them like you love your own. He has a beautiful allegory, a beautiful metaphor for this. He says all religions are like different compartments of one train going to the same destination, that is God, one God. So all religions are different compartments of one train. So he was against conversion. So he says it is not important, it is not necessary to change your compartment, because ultimately all of them are going to take you to the same destination. But then he warns, it is very important to clean your compartment from time to time. Otherwise it will become dirty, it will stink. And that is what is religious reform. That is what is religious reform. Every religion has to undergo reforms according to time, because again, another famous quote of Mahatma Gandhi is, Sab dharm acche hai, lekin sab dharm kacche bhi hai. All religions are good, but all religions are false, and it is important to recognize the faults and cleanse them. So mind you, Mahatma Gandhi is a student of all religions. He has studied Hinduism in depth, he has studied Quran in depth. So when he talks about reforming Hindu religion, he is also talking about reforming Quran. He is not afraid to do that, because he has understood it. Mahatma Gandhi is ready to challenge the scriptures of his own religion. If the scriptures are talking about untouchability, he says those scriptures should be thrown away. He has the courage to say that. All of us need to understand that Violence cannot take you to God. Violence will always take you away from God. To be divine is to be non-violent. Ahimsa is God. That's what Mahatma Gandhi believed. And that's why he tells us that a gun or a bomb can never bring you closer to God. Today, we are ridden. Our country and the world in general is ridden with a lot of religious violence. Factions are fighting. Different religions are fighting. Sects are fighting with each other. There's so much of bloodshed. I have chosen a very simple cartoon, which is a very good commentary on what is happening. This is a drawing of a rabbit, and it's also a drawing of a duck. Is it a duck or is it a rabbit? And the religious fight which is happening today is somewhat like this fight. Unless you give up your rabbit god and accept our duck god, there shall never be peace. This is the kind of a stupid fight which is happening in the name of religion in the country. Mahatma Gandhi was a saint who waded into politics. He was a very spiritual man. Desmond Tutu has a beautiful quote about it. He says that the transcendental and the spiritual accompanied Mahatma Gandhi everywhere. And I must add, Mahatma Gandhi was as spiritual, as transcendental when he was in a prayer meeting as he was in a protest meeting. When he was in a protest meeting, he was equally spiritual.
And the great soul was a great soul because he was always in touch with the transcendent.